the readings will be given by Dede from Georgia.
I will read from the Bible, King James Version. Proverbs. There are many devices in a man's heart. Nevertheless, the counsel of the Lord, that shall stand. Jonah. Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. And he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof, and went down into it, to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, so that the ship was like to be broken. Then the mariners were afraid, and cried every man unto his God. But Jonah was gone down into the sides of the ship, and he lay and was fast asleep. And they said every one to his fellow, Come, and let us cast lots, that we may know for whose cause this evil is upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. Then were the men exceedingly afraid, and said unto him, Why hast thou done this? For the men knew that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then said they unto him, What shall we do unto thee, that the sea may be calm unto us? And he said unto them, Take me up, and cast me forth into the sea, so shall the sea be calm unto you. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring it to the land, but they could not, for the sea wrought, and was tempestuous against them. Wherefore they cried unto the Lord and said, We beseech thee, O Lord, we beseech thee. Let us not perish for this man's life, for thou, O Lord, hast done as it pleased thee. So they took up Jonah and cast him forth into the sea, and the sea ceased from her raging. Now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah. And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights. Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord his God out of the fish's belly, and said, I cried by reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell cried I, and thou heardest my voice. Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward thy holy temple. They that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. I will pay that I have vowed. Salvation is of the Lord. And the Lord spake unto the fish, and it vomited out Jonah upon the dry land. And the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time, saying, Arise, go unto Nineveh, that great city, and preach unto it the preaching that I bid thee. So Jonah arose and went unto Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. And Jonah began to enter into the city a day's journey, and he cried and said, Yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. So the people of Nineveh believed God, and proclaimed a fast, and put on sackcloth, from the greatest of them even to the least of them. And God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way. And God repented of the evil that he had said that he would do unto them, and he did it not. Matthew. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. I will now read from Science and Health with Key to the Scriptures and Prose Works by Mary Baker Eddy. Mind's control over the universe, including man, is no longer an open question, but a demonstrable science. Obeying the divine principle, which you profess to understand and love, demonstrates truth. Never absent from your post, never off guard, never ill-humored, never unready to work for God, is obedience, being faithful over a few things. If in one instance obedience be lacking, you lose the scientific rule and its reward, namely, to be made ruler over many things. A progressive life is the reality of life that unfolds its immortal principle. Obedience is the offspring of love, and love is the principle of unity, the basis of all right thinking and acting. It fulfills the law. God's time and mortals differ. The neophyte is inclined to be too fast or too slow. He works somewhat in the dark and sometimes out of season. He would replenish his lamp at the midnight hour and borrow oil of the more provident watcher. God is the fountain of light, and he illumines one's way when one is obedient. The disobedient make their moves before God makes his, or make them too late to follow him. Be sure that God directs your way, then hasten to follow under every circumstance. Human will must be subjugated. We cannot obey both God good and evil. In other words, the material senses, false suggestions, self-will, selfish motives, and human policy. Honesty in every condition, under every circumstance, is the indispensable rule of obedience. The guerdon of meritorious faith or trustworthiness rests on being willing to work alone with God and for him, willing to suffer patiently for error until all error is destroyed and his rod and his staff comfort you. Self-ignorance, self-will, self-righteousness, lust, covetousness, envy, revenge are foes to grace, peace, and progress. They must be met manfully and overcome, or they will uproot all happiness. Be of good cheer. The warfare with oneself is grand. It gives one plenty of employment, and the divine principle worketh with you, and obedience crowns persistent effort with everlasting victory. Every attempt of evil to harm good is futile, and ends in the fiery punishment of the evildoer. Insubordination to the law of love, even in the least, or strict obedience thereto, tests and discriminates between the real and the unreal scientist. The professors of Christian Science must take off their shoes at our altars. They must unclasp the material sense of things at the very threshold of Christian Science. They must obey implicitly each and every injunction of the divine principle of life's long problem, or repeat their work in tears. In the words of St. Paul, "Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness?" Beloved students, loyal laborers are ye that have wrought valiantly and achieved great guerdons in the vineyard of our Lord. But a mighty victory is yet to be won, a great freedom for the race, and Christian success is under arms with armor on, not laid down. Let us rejoice, however, that the clarion call of peace will at length be heard above the din of battle, and come more sweetly to our ear than the sound of vintage bells to villagers on the Rhine. When love gains admittance to a humble heart, that individual ascends the scale of miracles and meets the warmest wish of men and angels. Clad in the invincible armor, grasping the sword of spirit, you have started in this sublime ascent and should reach the mount of revelation. For if ye would run, who shall hinder you? So dear, so due to God is obedience that it reaches high heaven in the common walks of life, and it affords even me a perquisite of joy.